Dear students, welcome the continuous sections of the design process. In previous lectures, we are covering this course objective and the outcomes and the various steps present in the machine designs and what are the essential factors for the designers through the previous lectures. So, in this session, we are going to discuss on the basic process of the machine design. And the basic process of the machine design consists of a step-by-step approaches for given specifications about the final requirement of the products to the complete descriptions in the form of the drawing of the final products. And the step by step, we have started the sixth basic step is present in the machine design. The first is a market survey. So, in the market survey, this step is consist of the preparing a complete list of the requirement of the products. And the requirement include the output capacity of that machines and its service life, cost and reliability. Even the market survey is depends on the two categories. If you are going to design the new products like as the innovations, and if you design the old product or the existing model products, so it's called as the modifications in the previous products. So it's a development. So it's innovation and the development. Those are the two things is present. And for the innovation as well as for the development, market survey is required. And from that, the market survey, you can find out the gaps related with that, the existing products and the new product which is required for the customers. Then second is the define the specifications of the products. When you decide the products from the markets, this product is available for the customers or is a need for the customers, either some gap is present between the existing products. Then you can define the proper specification of that product. So, example, if you design some electric motors, then you can decide the capacity of the electric motor, the HP of that electrical motor, the speed of that electrical motor, and either maybe for the agriculture purpose, you design the pump, what should the head of that the pump, what should the flow rate of that the pump. So these are the different specification you can decide for that the products. Then next is this, study the alternative mechanisms. Study the alternative mechanisms for products and select the proper mechanisms. So after carefully study the requirement, the designer prepares rough sketches of the different possible mechanisms for the products. Through that products, the different linkage is there, different mechanism is present. So our aim is to select the proper mechanisms for that such application. So number of elements is available in the markets, and our aim is to select the simple elements for assembly of that the different elements. So here, need to develop the proper mechanisms for that machines. So simplicity is the major roles for development of any machine components. The next step is to prepare the general layout of configurations and selecting the joining methods between the individual components of the products. In these steps, the design produces is to prepare a block diagram showing the general layout of the selected configurations. For example, the layout of the electrically operated overhead traveling crane will be consist of the following components, like as electrical motors for the power supply, then the flexible coupling for join the shaft and the clutches, then clutch to connect the disconnect the electrical motors. So here, proper layout is required for that machining assembly, starting from first element to the last elements. Then next is the design the individual components. The design of the individual components or machine elements is an important step in design process. It consists the various stages is present in this step. The first is, suppose example, determine the forces acting on that the components. And second, select the proper material for the components depending upon the functional requirement, such as the strength, rigidity, hardness and wear resistance. Then determine the modes of failure for the components, and depending upon it, select the criteria of the failure, such as the yielding strength, ultimate tensile strength, entrance limit or the permissible stresses. Even determine the geometrical dimensions of the component using the suitable factor of the safety, and modify the dimensions from assembly and manufacturing the considerations. And last step for this machine design is to prepare assembly and detailed drawing and modify the drawing after the testing prototype model. In this last stage, in the design process, it is to prepare drawing of the assembly and the individual components on the basis of these drawings, the material of the component, its dimensions, tolerances, surface finish grade, and machining symbols are specified. The designer prepares two separate lists of the components standards components to be purchased directly from the market and specific component to be machined in the factory. In many cases, a prototype model is prepared for the product and thoroughly tested before finalizing the assembly drawing. This is a typical process is present for design the machine's components. The next, the basic requirement of the machine elements. The basic requirement of the machine elements. In this, each part of the machine which has motion with respect to the some other parts is called as the machine element. And it is important to note that the each machine element may consist of the several parts which are manufactured separately. The objective of designing machine element is to ensure that it preserves its operating capacity during the stipulated service life with minimum manufacturing and operating cost. In order to achieve this objective, the machine element should satisfy the various basic requirements, and this basic requirement based on the various criteria, like as a suppose strength. In the strength, a machine part should not fail under the effect of the forces that act on it, and it should have sufficient strength to avoid failure either due to the fractures or due to the general yielding. Second is the rigidity. A machine component should be rigid, that it should be not defected or bent too much due to the forces or movement that act on it. Example, the shaft of the vehicles. Then the wear resistance. Wear is the main reasons for putting the machine part out of order. It reduces the useful life of the component. Wear also leads to the loss of accuracy of machine tools. There are the different types of the wear, such as the abrasive wear, corrosive wear, and the fitting wears. Then the minimum dimensions and the weight is depends on the applications of that the components. A machine part should be sufficiently strong, rigid, and wear resistance, and at the same time with minimum possible dimensions and the weight. This will result in the minimum material cost. The next step is the manufacturability. Manufacturability is the easy of the fabrication and the assembly. The shape and material of the machine part should be selected in such way that it can be produced with minimum labor cost. The next is safety. The shape and the dimensions of the machine part should ensure safety to the operators of the machines. The designer should assume the worst possible condition and apply the fail-safe principle in such cases. The next is a conformance to the standards. A machine part should conform to the national and international standards covering profile, dimensions, grade, and the material, like SGC standard, Euro standards, ISI standard, the various standard is present. The next step is the reliability. In reliability, it is the probability that a machine part will perform its intended functions under the design operating conditions over the specific period of the time. A machine part should be reliable, that it should perform the functions satisfactory over its lifetime. The next is the maintainability. A machine part should be maintainable, and it's easy to maintain the parts during the service or is repaired. The last is the minimum life cycle cost. The life cycle cost of the machine part is the total cost to be paid by the purchaser for purchasing the part and operating and maintaining it over its lifespan. So it will be observed that the above mentioned requirement serves a basic of the design projects in many cases, like as strength, rigidity, wear resistance, minimum dimensions and the weights, the manufacturability, safety, conformance to the standards, reliability, maintainability, minimum life cost cycle example. So the one example about the standards. The number of companies are manufacturing the bulbs. The wattage of the bulb is different: 10 watt, 20 watt, 30 watt, 40 watt, 60 watt, etc. But the bulb holder is standards. This holder is suitable for each and every watt conditions bulb, like as the 10 watt, 20 watts. So it is a standardization about that the holders. Even the dimensions, the number of standard is present. Example, if you purchase the some products from the market, the standard dimension is given. It may be in the number or it may be in the alphabets. These are all these requirements are the basic of the design projects in many cases. So in next lecture, we are going to discuss on the design of different machine elements based on the various process. Thank you.